ski.
Some weird, wild stuff. That is funny. I did not know that.
Yes!
Dropping drawers and stabbing whores on the Kevin Holly Show.
And I gotta say, he has balls. This man has balls. He's flinging them out there for us to see.
That's it. It sounds like our first date kit.
Ever shared a lustful evening with a Muslim woman?
We're dropping drawers and stabbing whores. It's the Kevin Holly Show. Says El Tiempo para más de la Kevin Holly Show. Go!
Oh, baby. I dedicate this to all the pretty girls. All the pretty girls. It's all. All the pretty girls in the world. And the ugly girls, too. Because to me, you're pretty anyways, baby. You give me your number, I call you up. You act like your pussy don't interrupt. I don't have no problem with you fucking me, but I have a little problem with you not fucking me. Baby, you know I'll take care of you, cause you say you got my baby and I know it ain't true. Is it a good thing? No, it's bad, bitch. For good or worse, makes you switch. So I walk on over with my crystal. Bitches, N-word. Put away your pistols. Bemis won't be having it in this house, cause bitch, I'll cripple your style. Now that you heard my calm voice, you can get another N-word. Coochie won't get moist. If you wanna look good and not be bummy, girl, you better give me that money.
Who? Hey, dirty. Baby, I got your money, don't you worry. Said hey, baby, I got your money.
So I glanced at the girls. Girls glanced at me. I whispered in their ear.
You wanna be with me?
You wanna look pretty though in my video. Old Bemis on the hat, and I'll let you all know. Just dance if you're caught up in the Holy Ghost trance. If you stop, I'll put the killer ants in your pants. I'm the MAB, as you can see. FBI, don't you be watching me. I don't want no problems cause I put you down in the ground where you cannot be found. I'm just Beam Dog trying to make some money. So give me my streets and give me my honey. Radios play this all day, every day. Recognize I'm a fool and you love me. None of you better look at me funny. You know my name now, give me my money.
Hey, dirty.
Sing it.
Baby, I got your money.
Sing it, girl.
Said, hey,
sing it right now.
Baby, I got your money.
Yo, if Bemis,
hey,
wants his money, just
dirty,
give him his money.
Baby, I got your
That's
money.
How I like
got
it, girl. Yo, yo, banging in the club like this all night. Bitches, put your ass out, let me hold it tight. You're looking at my wrist saying, it's so nice. The price, bitch, is diamonds. Shining disco light. You better help me solve my problem, or I'll get this money and rob them. Lucky dog when I won the lotto. Ran up on my car for carrying Rollos. Well, hold on, you can call me Bemis, and then lift up your skirt. And if you want this Bemis, God made Beam, and Beam will bust your ass. Stop annoying me, yeah, I play my music loud. It takes the bastard old Bemis to move the crowd. They say he had his balls in his mouth. Cisco Adler taught me that back in the
But
house.
Give me my money!
Hey, dirty, come here,
through Kevin's medicine cabinet and I found a devil beaver dildo there in preparation H.
Welcome back to the Kevin Holly Show. If you like us, you probably got the herpes.
Seriously, Pops?
That didn't make any chucking sense. What the chuck did Pops just say?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I've been listening to the Kevin Harding Show here for the last few weeks, and it really does something for me. I'll tell you, it reminds me of an orgasm. I remember the best thing about an orgasm, I can remember the fantastic satisfaction and feeling of helping my female partner attain a great one.
Seriously, Pops?
I don't think you guys know what an atheist is, do you? One thing about, with all this dissension with black and white and religion with Muslims and all that, there's one thing that really you have to think about, and that's our Bill of Rights gives people the right to worship as they wish. And of course, that means of the 10,000 religions with 1,000 gods, they've got quite a choice. And nobody can mess with them if they believe that. But now if an atheist says he doesn't want to accept any one of those gods, even though he's surrounded by people who have found the one true one that they think is given them a savior that will save them from all of their sins of their fathers and everybody else. They don't really like to talk about their own sins, but...
If I could interject a little something at this moment, I'd just like to take a...
Six of their three children have... I mean, three of their six children have drowned. The other three were burned in a fire. They've lost a fire. They've lost a houseboat. They've lost $500,000 in a bad business deal, and yet they still believe in something.
If I could ask a question here, you said six of their three children drowned.
Then I changed
and
it to
then
three.
Okay, okay.
Then I said three of their six children drowned and three of them burned in a fire.
And they lost the fire and their houseboat.
Yeah, and yet they still have this blind faith, you know, because that guy that gave them their Lord and Savior is looking after them and taking care of them.
Maybe
this is a thing that atheists have a hard time dealing with, but yet these people with this blind faith, they keep going on whistling and singing and happily ever after.
That didn't make any chucking sense. What the chuck did Pops just say?
What the chuck did Chuck just say?
Chuck, could you shut the fuck up for a second, please?
A lot of my friends are animals. Some of them are actually two are bipedal, but they're still animals.
That did not make any chucking sense. What the chuck did Chuck just say?
Drinking dragon's blood, just like Charlie Sheen, I'm a winner.
Oh, no, when I play with myself, I think about Tupac.
What the chuck did Chuck just say?
All right, this is the time of the night where we call Brother Phil because he won't stop blowing my phone up. As best as we can get him.
Hello?
Hey, can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Can I hear what?
Can you hear Pops?
I'm talking to the mic, man.
Can you hear me now?
I can hear Pops. Is that new Jay?
New Chuck.
New Chuck, whatever. Jay. New Jay, you didn't need Jay because Jay's kind of lame.
Jay's busy, he's eating something right now.
Cock.
Yeah, probably.
He's in the jack room backing off.
So, what's up, PJ?
Not much. Walking the dog.
Yeah, is that what you call it? How's that rash?
Pretty good.
Yeah?
I was setting up my... security camera tonight, trying to get the position right and everything. It's pretty important because I got to be able to see your girlfriend and her nastiness. And it's working pretty good.
There's no nastiness, man.
Yeah, no, it's pretty nasty.
Did you say he has a rash?
Yeah, he's got a bad rash, Pops.
Is it contagious?
Probably. I think all rashes are contagious.
Did he say he was setting up some kitty cameras?
I think he's setting
up... It's only contagious a couple of times a month.
Yeah. Well, tell us more about those kitty cameras you're setting up.
Well, I got one set up in my front yard, pointed at your house, and I'm watching your family right now, and I'm watching your girlfriend, and I don't like what she's doing, dude. You might want to check up on her.
Yeah? What, is she sleeping? Yeah. Is she sleeping or what?
No, she's got some homeless guy over there right now.
How do you know he's homeless? Is homeless Chuck over there?
Holy shit. Chuck is over at Kevin's.
Oh, my God, dude. I can't believe that.
No wonder he's not here tonight.
Nah, seriously, homeless Chuck didn't show up because he's working, but that might be code for he can't start his minivan. I don't know.
Could be.
Or he's at my house.
Or he's at a bear run.
What's a bear run?
Beer run. Oh, did I miss beer run tonight?
Excuse me, PJ, I'd like to...
You gotta talk into the phone, bro.
A bear run does not exist.
I was all excited to call in for beer talk because I had a couple of Molson tonight.
Yeah, were they golden?
No, just regular old Molson.
Listen, we already have a beer guy, PJ. I understand you're trying to. You can't.
We got a beer guy.
You got a beer guy,
but I drink real beer, though.
Hey, Phil. Yeah. That rash that's contagious twice a month?
Yeah, every couple of months.
Does it bleed?
It depends on how you touch it.
Oh, I didn't want to touch it. Hey, Phil.
It only hurts when it's on my ass.
Phil, forget your ass. I mean, you are married, right?
Yes, I am.
You got any nude pictures of your wife?
Do you want some?
Well, I was going to ask. I got some neat ones. I'd sell you real reasonable.
I would show them to you, except that at your age, you might not be able to handle them.
No, I don't handle anything anymore like that.
That's not what I heard. I heard you handle quite a bit, like about 4 inches.
That you're stretching it about 3 inches.
Well, we're talking about Kevin.
let me tell you what I remember about an orgasm, kid.
I remember, hold on, let me sit down. This could take a while.
Just listen. best lesson you've ever had.
Is this like your own account? Or
what I remember about
something you would. What I remember about witnessing somebody else have one.
No, what I remember about an orgasm is a fantastic feelings of satisfaction.
Yeah.
During and after helping my female partner achieve a great one.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to see the footage on that because I don't believe it ever happened.
Well, it's because PJ's never actually seen that happen firsthand. Yeah. You know? So
he's never made a woman happy. Huh?
I don't think so. I know. I don't think so.
That could be true, but I am married to Kevin's ex-girlfriend. Hey, so what does that say about Kevin?
That's arguable. That is actually to be proven.
I was going to say that I only got an inch between my legs, but I could sure steal your wife.
That inch is between your ass.
I don't need that. I don't need what's in between my legs to make her happy.
Oh, man. Hey, I just...
You know, it's funny because Kevin was telling me about how he likes to clean that inch between your ass and your ball sack when you need a cleansing.
Well, no, that was actually a flensing. It's totally different. Flensing's different. But, you know, as Chuck would say...
Well, Jay and Kevin here... They love a woman who likes a small penis. I like a woman who enjoys helping her man find his.
Let me ask you this, new Chuck. Have you ever seen Kevin?
Hey, forget that Chuck shit. I'm Pops.
Pops, have you ever seen Kevin's penis? Because there's pieces of it that are missing. Ask him about that.
It's 100% true. I'll show him. You know, it's funny you said that because one day I came over to Jay's house to meet him. It's about 2 years ago. And I texted Jay and I said, hey, you know, I'm on my way over. I drove by earlier. Your car wasn't there. He said you'd be there. What's up? And he texted me back. He's like, I'm on my way. I'll be there in a little bit. I'm at Cash and Carry, you know. And he said, just go ahead and let yourself in. Pops will be there. And I said, well, I just pulled up. And I'm standing next to your air conditioning unit outside. I'm about to take a piss. And he goes, well, hold on a second. Pops will probably want to see your dick. And I said, no, whatever, dude. And, dude, no sooner than I unzipped my pants, like 5 seconds later, I got my junk in my hand, and I'm about to start letting the stream go. And I hear the front door kick open, and Pops comes over with the garbage, throws it in the can, and goes, oh, hey, Kevin, come here. I want to see your cock. So Jay must have texted Pops like while we were texting.
He said he wanted to show you his cock.
Oh, yeah, something like that. I don't know, whatever. That's a, no, it's true, though, but he never did see it.
It was a setup, I'm sure.
So,
he never got to see it.
So, Pops, what did you think of it?
He never got to see it.
Never got to see it?
You want
to
see it now, Pops?
Kevin loves seeing Pop's cock, though.
Mm-mm. That's poppycock, man.
Yeah.
Popsicle.
You know, every time we talk to PJ, it's all about cocks, man. What's up with that?
It's the cock hour with PJ.
I guess so. You know, I went golfing with PJ once, and he shot a birdie on the third hole. Turned out it was a swallow.
It was. I admit it. One of the best days I ever had golfing.
Yeah, well, not for me. Hey, speaking of golfing.
So what?
What?
Yeah?
Speaking
I was going to ask you, what's going on there tonight?
A whole lot of nothing, man.
Really?
Yeah, I'm being really dumb, and I had the headphones plugged into the microphone for like a half an hour, and that was awesome.
Wow, that's smart.
It's brilliant, yeah.
We're doing it. We're having some good material tonight.
Yeah, we did, actually. We did a little trivia. Pops got laid tonight.
Oh, man. I would have been good with... You got laid, Pops?
Sure.
Wow. Is there, like, film of that, or am I just taking somebody's word for it?
No, it was Kevin.
I filmed it.
That doesn't count.
What? Why not?
Seriously, I would have been really good at trivia, though. I'm a little upset that I missed trivia. Well,
let's do some trivia right now.
In prison.
You can't stump me.
Let's do some trivia right now.
Let's do it.
Is there any particular trivia that you prefer?
No, man.
Okay, I got something loaded up right now.
All right.
Let's do there's the top 10 worst foods in America that you could possibly eat, okay?
Worst foods in America?
Yeah, top 10 worst foods that you could possibly put into your body. Let me get a piece of
paper.
And
it doesn't count anything that your girlfriend's ever cooked, right?
No, man. No. Of course
or
not.
Our mother.
Or our mother, sure. Or your girlfriend's mother. All right, hold on a second. Let me, you got me on the spot here, Phil, so I'm just going to have to flip a page here. All right, draw a little grid. We got PJ, we've got Pops, and we got Jay. And I'll be the...
You guys are going down.
I'm the keeper of
trivia. Which is nothing new for any of them.
Yeah, Jay's already trying to cheat. But don't worry about Pops cheating. He can't see here. Okay. All right, we got a top 10 list of the worst foods you could possibly eat. And So if anybody wants to go ahead... wait a minute. Jay... Don't you got the background music for trivia?
Yeah,
turn that on,
right,
man.
Now. It's on.
What do you mean it's on? Is it looping right now?
Turn it up, yeah.
I don't have it here. Oh, wait.
It's trivia. I'm the Kevin Howard Show. It's trivia. Come on, let's go. It's trivia.
Whoa, Pops, you're hitting buttons here. Pops has got his magnifying glass on my tablet. He's trying to cheat, dude. He's hitting buttons on it. It's flipping pages. Hold on, I got it. Okay. Phil, can you hear the background music?
No.
Good. Not supposed to. Okay. Background music is turned down. Okay. Who wants to go first? Just say your name, and then I'll...
Jay.
Jay, what's your first one?
Tombstone Pizza.
Tombstone Pizza is not on the list. Sorry. I don't have a buzzer right now, so... What? Wait a minute. I lost PJ. I turned him down.
I'm right here.
There, he's back.
I'm right here.
Phil's back.
I'm trying to figure out how that's trivia where you just say your name and then shout out a food.
Well, it's a top 10 list, so.
The worst food you can eat, Bob's is going to say spaghetti when your girlfriend has got her period.
What?
Hold on a second, dude. Pops said spaghetti when your girlfriend has her period, and Pops, that's correct. Good job. Ding, ding. Pops got one. All right.
I wanted to say that.
Sorry. Pasta and white bread is on the list. That's number 10, actually. So, Pops, you got that. Number 10 answer. Okay. PJ, do you have an answer for the top 10 list of the worst foods you could possibly eat in America?
Worst foods you could possibly eat? Fried possum and maggot sauce?
No, come on, man. Be serious. That's something you eat every day.
So, you eat spaghetti every day when your girlfriend's on her period?
Well,
I don't get it.
Pasta,
I don't understand.
Pasta was on the list. Okay. Whether or not it's with your girlfriend and her period doesn't matter. Pasta's on the list.
Okay. So. I'm going to go with... It's got to be something to do with liver and onions.
Liver and onions is not on the list.
Oh, come on.
Sorry, buddy.
That's wholesome food, man.
Jay, do you have something for the top 10 list? Don't cheat. Good looking.
Yeah, I'm going to say, how about... The Hungry Man Frozen Dinner.
Oh, Frozen Dinner.
Those are awesome.
Number 2 on the list, Frozen Dinner. Well done.
This is fucking fixed.
Oh, wait a minute, man. It's Chuck and Fixed? No, it's not.
Yeah.
All right, Phil, your turn.
Okay, I'm going to go with Ramen Noodle.
That would be under the pasta category. Already answered. Sorry.
Oh, come on. What? This is totally fixed.
It's not fixed.
Ramen Noodles are great.
It's fixed.
So, Pops, do you have an answer?
Can I interject with them?
No, it's Pops' turn.
Oh, come on. Pops don't got nothing. Come on.
Come on, Pops. Top 10 worst food you can eat in America.
The worst food.
One. Two.
I'm going to take a bye on this.
What? Bye what? What do you mean a bye? What is this, a football pool? What do you mean?
No. Wait, just...
He's so used to my cooking, he can't respond. All right,
okay. Jay, I think you're next.
All right. I would say...
I am going to have to say... Hot dog hamburger helper.
Processed meats, definitely on the list. Jay.
This is total bullshit. Total bullshit.
No, processed meats. He said hot dogs. That's on the list. All right, PJ, you're next. You got one.
Yeah, collard greens.
I love collard greens. What are you talking about?
Vegetables.
Collard greens?
Not on the list.
That's absolutely healthy for you.
I can't even find the list anymore. I lost it.
I'm going with Mississippi catfish.
This is not the best food category.
Fried elephant ears.
It's the worst.
Donuts and pastries on the list. Pops. Bing, 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 bing.
All
right.
You guys are all looking at the list. I can't
see the list, man.
Pops says blind, dude. Why you got to bully up on a blind guy, PJ? What the hell?
Oh, my God.
It's just a game, man. It's just a game, Phil.
He's like the guy that beat up on the blind guy.
There's going to be a football player get suspended because of you if you don't cut out beating on me.
First of all, if he's blind and he's talking about eating this stuff, he doesn't even know if he's really eating it. You could like feed him fucking Pop-Tarts and tell him whatever he just said.
He already said pastries.
I do that all the time.
I used to sell tools in the inner city of Milwaukee, and you couldn't get a blind guy to eat spaghetti from his girlfriend, period, whether she was menstruating or not.
But that was like 1932, though.
No, when my son was born, he was 8 years old, so it's 30 years ago.
Exactly, that's my point.
Okay, Phil, do you have a freaking top 10 food that's on the list?
Whatever I say is not going to be, okay, I got a top 10 worst food.
Serious. Be serious.
Worst food you could possibly eat. Anything that you would find at an open-air Chinese market.
Sorry, Phil.
Come on.
Chinese food.
Yeah. Oh, Chinese food is one of the best things you can eat, right, Pop?
Chinese food's healthy, man. Yeah. Those guys are skinny.
Yeah, so rat on a...
Well, here's kimchi.
rat on a stick is healthy, apparently, because that's what you would get at an open air.
You guys don't know what kimchi is, I'm sure. But it's
I just talked to kimchi earlier today. Fucking guy doesn't know nothing about IT.
Kimchi is like a carrot, only it's yellow, right yellow. And I smelt it. I never ate any of it, but I could never get close enough to it to
wait,
eat.
Is smelt on the list?
It's smelt.
Kevin, didn't you smoke?
It's like a root.
And, did you smoke kimchi when you were in high school, Kevin?
I ran into this in Korea.
No.
Kimchi.
I think Kevin used to smoke kimchi when he was in high school. Oh, no, that was Kenji. Never mind.
Damn. All right, I got the list back. All right, so the score right now is Jay has 2, Pops has 2, Phil has nothing. And we've got pastries, we've got top 10 worst foods in America that you can eat, frozen food, Hungry Man, Jay got that, processed meats, Jay got, Pops with donuts, and pasta when your girlfriend's on her period. So there's still 6 more. Phil, can you
please?
I'm going
to have to go with Subway cookies.
I'm trying here, guys. Fine.
Sorry.
Subway cookies.
Wait a minute. Let me check the list here. Subway cookies. Sorry, Jay. Not on the list.
Subway cookies? Wow.
Nope. Pops, you got one?
They're good for you, Pops. Those are good for you.
I'm going to say...
I'm going with any meal that you would get in San Quentin.
Prison food? Let me look.
Prison food.
I'm sorry, Phil. Not
on
the list.
Come on.
Pops, do you have one?
Yeah.
This is not trivia.
Shit on a shingle.
Okay, Pops, shit on a shingle. On the list. All right. That's going to be low-fat foods in general. Pops, way to go. Okay, Pops 3, Jay 5 at the halfway point. Jay, you're next.
I got to give that one to Pops. That was a pretty good one.
All right. I'm going to say soft drinks. Any kind of Pepsi, Dr. Pepper.
Oh, Coke, number 7 on the list. Soda. Jay ties up the game. 3-3, Jay and Pops in a deadlock for the lead.
How about this? How about Jay and Pops, you guys agree next one win?
Okay. Well, they got to agree with that.
There's no way I lose with my next guest. Pixie sticks.
Let's see. Candy. Is candy on the list?
I'm not giving them. I'm not.
Duh. Hell no.
Yeah, but hey, give him that one. 69 is, and he guessed that.
Okay, Pops.
You don't eat the 69. You just lick it. You either got to be the sucker or the sucky. That's all.
Good Lord. And let me check the list. Let's see here. And Pops, Frappuccino on the list. Okay, Pops got 4.
We gave that to him.
Oh, you're right. PJ got 1. Okay.
We switched it to the 69.
Listen, there's only 3 left. So
yeah,
we
said that was the winner right there.
Okay.
Oh, you want to go for first and second runner up or between?
Sure, tiebreaker, whatever. Okay.
Oh, we'll let him compete.
Double or nothing.
He'd be the grand champion.
There's only 3 left. Only 3 left.
Well, there's one for each of us.
Name a food, Phil, that you're not allowed to eat, and you'll probably get one on the list.
Baklava.
Pussy.
Baklava would fall under...
It's on there.
No, but PJ can't have pussy, but... Okay, no. How about Cinnabon's baklava? Same shit. Number 9 on the list, Phil.
Oh, there are you malakas. Cinnabon malaka, no.
Okay,
Cinnabon malaka,
okay.
No. Hey, Stokola Sue.
Hey, calm down.
Stokola Sue.
Calm down. Get this free guy out of here. Pipe down, Yanni. Yanni, pipe down. Yanni, get back in the kitchen, Yanni. Get back in the kitchen, Yanni. Okay, Yanni's gone. Sorry about that. Opa. All right.
There's one left. I got it. I know what it is.
Okay,
it's very popular in Europe.
No.
At least it was during World War II. It's called juice.
Juice.
You need a really big oven for those, though.
Not on the list. Sorry. Phil, there's one food that you have to stay away from for your cholesterol. Okay? It's number six on the list. One kind of food.
That's easy.
It's not even really a
food. Your girlfriend.
It's a bottle of salt.
Nope. It's, come on, you guys, the last
ice
one.
Ice cream.
Liquor?
Could it be
cholesterol?
Yeah, what do you stay away from if you're not supposed to have cholesterol?
Fat pork.
Eggs?
Fat pork?
Yeah.
What do you buy fat pork from? What the hell is fat pork?
What are you ain't you never had fat back, Kevin?
No, man. Sorry.
Oh, man. You
guys suck. It's margarine. This game's over. That's a wash. You could have tied it with margarine, Phil. I gave you all the clues, man.
Hey, do I get a free shirt or what?
It's a wash. Jay and Pop's tied.
I get a free shirt, right?
You get nothing. You guys suck.
I don't get jack.
You guys ready for a golf joke?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, these four guys have been playing golf every Friday for the last 5 years. And this week, the one guy says, you know, next week we're going to be in trouble because Christmas is on Friday, and there's no way my wife's going to let me out. And the other, oh, yeah, we'll have to call it off. And the other guy says, yeah, mine won't let me do it. And the other guy says, look, you chintzy bastard, we're going to play golf. We ain't going to break this just because it's Christmas. You got to get control with your wife. So they go, and the following Friday, they're all at the golf course. One guy says, hope you guys appreciate that I'm here. He says, I had to buy my wife a mink coat. Cost me $3,000. The other guy says, that ain't bad. I had to buy my wife a Corvette. It cost me $25,000. The other guy said, I had to promise my wife a trip around the world. It's going to cost me over $30,000. You guys ain't know how to do it. He says, I got up this morning. I said, okay, honey, what's it going to be, golf course or intercourse? She says, better take your jacket. It's going to be chilly.
Yeah. Oh, I get it. It's going to be chilly. I get it.
I don't get it.
He says, he got up out of bed, and he said to his wife, okay, honey, I'm going to go golfing. Or what do you want? Golf course or intercourse.
Why are you yelling at me, old man? What the hell? You know what this? You know who I am? It's the Kevin Holly Show. You don't yell at me. You know what, Jay? You better check your dad, man. You better check your dad.
No, man. If you want to get drunk out of the studio right now, man.
That's all right. Forget about it.
You guys want to get in trouble?
No.
You just behave or I'll quit.
Oh, don't do that. Don't do that.
What are you guys? Is Pops going to take you out on like some kind of midnight run? You guys are going to get in trouble with a couple of blockheads and characters?
Could be, maybe.
Did you knock over the malt shop?
Did you tell your bro what a buddy is?
No, what's a buddy?
Should we tell him? Is he old enough to know?
He's old enough to know. He's older than me.
I'm older than Kevin is.
Oh. You know what a buddy is?
I think so.
What is a buddy to you? I'll tell you what a buddy is. Hell, you don't know. It's a guy that goes down and goes downtown and gets two blowjobs, and he comes home and gives you one.
Hey, Pops. Did you hear the Pope was here recently?
Yeah, I saw him all
day. Seen him all week, right? He was walking around New York City.
Yep,
and a couple of women kept coming up to him. Blowjob, father? And he's like, what? And everywhere he went, on every block, there was another woman asking him, blowjob, father? And he finally got to the main Catholic church there in Boston. The name escapes me, the name of the church. He got in, he saw the head nun. He's like, hey, everywhere I've gone today, people have been asking me for a blowjob. What's a blowjob? And she said, it's about $5. You want one?
Very good, very good. I don't get it.
Oh, Jesus, man. Hey, I got one for you. How do you get a nun pregnant?
Fucker?
Dress her up like an altar boy.
Yeah,
Yeah. Is this thing on?
Yeah, it's on, dude. Hey, Pops, have you seen Kevin's girlfriend?
Oh, man, I love her.
She's a big girl, though.
Huh?
She's a big girl.
She's not a big girl.
No, she's a big girl. So the other day, she was getting the mail. Cops came by and told her to break it up.
Have you seen PJ's wife, Pops?
That is that the one you broke your back carrying?
Yeah, I bumped into her at the supermarket, and I said, oh, excuse me, my mistake. And she went, huh, what? Someone say steak?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Okay. All right, these jokes suck, dude.
Yeah,
don't say anything bad about Lori. I love Lori.
There you go. Pops loves Lori.
Everybody loves Lori.
A couple days a week, actually.
Now you're getting nasty, buddy. We're start calling you bad names if you keep.
As a matter of fact, I'm walking over there right now, Kevin.
Are you really? Hey, would you do me a favor?
No. Sure.
You make sure my doors are locked, my windows are shut, and my chihuahua's.
Throw some chlorine in your pool.
Yeah, throw some chlorine in the pool. If you could weed whack, that'd be great.
Hey. And to trim too while you're there. John.
Yeah, if you could trim the bush, is.
Pick up all the dog shit in the front yard too. Yeah, if you could, I'll
trim the bush all right.
Actually, I let my dog shit in Phil's yard. He lives on my street. No big deal.
We'd really appreciate if you'd stop voting for Obama or Hillary Clinton too.
Yeah, Phil, can you take that Obama sign now?
Don't worry about that.
All right, well, we're going to go ahead and end this phone call with Brother Phil because we've got Chuck, Bob, and Joe on the hotlines here.
Steve,
on
hold. Oh,
yeah.
Steve's on five? All right, Steve, if you can just hold on, wait. We got tickets to give away for the Richard
shirts.
Benson concert. Motivational
speech. Kevin Holly shirts.
Yeah, Kevin Holly shirts on the line. Ninth caller that calls in with something better than Brother Phil's BS call.
Exactly.
The next person
Do me a favor, Tell Chuck I said I'm sorry and I didn't mean the things that I said to him. Hopefully, later tonight we can get together and hook up and, make amends.
What do you mean?
Chuck's not here, man.
Chuck's not here.
I thought he was on the phone.
No, you're on the phone, dumbass.
You said Chuck was on the phone.
Oh, he's on hold, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Duh, who's the dumbass now? Yeah!
Hey-o! Hey-o! Ha, ha, ha! Yes! Oh, he hung up!
Food
fed. He hung up! Are you kidding me? I can't believe you hung up, dude.
What do you want from a Holly?
Did he hang up?
He did. He fucking hung up. He chucking hung up.
What a real chucker.
Oh, no, when I play with my
son,
I think about you, Pop.
Oh, Kevin. No, I'm going to say, let me see. What was I saying? Oh.
I'd like to thank you for listening to the Kevin Holly Show. I hope you have as much fun as you
have. I never wanted to be president, because it's nothing but an ego trip, yeah. I didn't want your education, because it's nothing but a pile of shit. You bore me to death, so shut up for God's sake. Stop bringing me the riot act while my brains are still intact. You say it's raining, but you're pissing down my back.
What I meant was, have you ever had lust with one? Ever shared a lustful evening with a Muslim woman?